Hello, it's Kelly here from Spiritual Awakening Signs, and I help people like you who are going through spiritual awakening to reduce your symptoms and make the whole process a whole lot easier. And we're kind of getting into that today. So this video is all about really how to tell if your anxiety is being caused by spiritual awakening. There are a few key ways to tell, and we're going to make sure you know for sure by the end of this video. That's what we're getting into. So let's make it really quick. We'll just get into all the information. Let's talk first of all about some of the symptoms that you might get as part of your anxiety, just so that we can really ensure that that's exactly what we're talking about and we're being really clear on what we're tackling right now. So the symptoms of anxiety that you would usually get are things like feelings of nervousness, restless, you might feel unsettled, you might feel kind of tense. You might have a sense of impending doom. That used to happen to me all the time in my awakening. I had terrible anxiety. I always felt like there was something really, really wrong, that there was danger coming, there was something to dread. You might be sweating, you might even be shaking. You could be feeling weak, kind of like a blood sugar dip. You can get that kind of sense from it. You might have brain fog. You might have trouble concentrating or difficulty expressing your words or what it is that you really want to say. You might have trouble thinking clearly as well. Butterflies, churning, knots in the stomach are all big indicators of anxiety as well. You just get that bad gut feeling. It's like a bad feeling in your gut, as if you're picking up on something. Feeling lightheaded and dizzy can even occur. Feeling nauseous. And of course, things like pins and needles in the extremities, tingling, that can happen if you're really getting to that extreme level of fight or flight. So it's not good. So before we get into the key indicators, I just want to say hi to everyone who's watching us live. Please let me know who you are and where you're from. I love to hear from you guys. And tell me, share your experience of anxiety on the awakening pathway, because it's so common. Almost everyone goes through anxiety throughout this spiritual awakening process. So it's a very, very common theme, and a lot of us feel really isolated and alone and don't know what to do about it. So that's what we're going to make sure that we're covering here. So let's talk about the key indicators that we have, whether it's spiritual awakening anxiety or whether it's just normal anxiety, okay? And they're both awful. Anxiety just in general is awful. But if you want to know if it's really spiritual awakening anxiety, you're looking for three key things. There's three key ways to really tell the difference. Number one would be it has no discernible cause. So the anxiety that you're feeling, you might notice that it's not connected to anything. It just rises up all of a sudden, or you wake up and it's already there. It doesn't necessarily seem to be connected to life events. Okay, it can be, but generally it's just all of a sudden it's like, whoa, I feel really afraid. I feel really anxious and I don't know why. So you're really looking for that key sign of I feel anxious and I'm not sure why. Okay, that would be an indicator that it is actually down to spiritual awakening. Number two is that it intensifies around electrical items and objects that emit frequency. So you might notice that it tends to get worse when you've had the TV on all day, or you've been sitting on the laptop for too long, or maybe you've been using your phone for extended periods of time. Maybe you're so sensitive it's even just being around Wi-Fi, or there's EMFs, there's towers nearby or something like that. Anything that emits a frequency, if it makes your anxiety worse, it's most likely affecting your energies, which therefore means it's due to spiritual awakening. Okay, the other one we've got is that it massively reduces when you avoid spiritual objects and spiritual practices. So this would be my tip for you, and we've got a free masterclass that I'm going to share with you in a moment that will teach you everything you need to know and help you out with your spiritual awakening anxiety to get rid of it for good. But right now, what I would say is, if you take a break from spiritual objects, things like crystals, incense, essential oils, sage, if you just move them out of your current living space, put them in a box, put them in the furthest corner of the home, as far away from you as possible, put them in the garage, give them to someone else for a week or two, get them out of your energetic space, okay? And you also want to take a break from any spiritual practices. Don't worry, you can add all these things back in, but we're just testing it. You want to take a break from spiritual practices like yoga, like meditation, any form of kind of ceremony or practice that you're doing. You want to take a break. Now, sometimes, literally, just the difference of 3 or 4 days, you'll notice your anxiety drops massively. We have a review on our site where someone actually dropped their anxiety by 80% simply by following those guidelines. So you can try that. But if you use it for up to 2 weeks and your anxiety is completely gone or massively reduced, it's definitely because of spiritual awakening, because that means that these objects have an energetic frequency and they're affecting your energy. And your energy tends to get really affected when we're going through spiritual awakening, so that would be a key indicator. And of course, the most obvious sign that it's caused by spiritual awakening is if you're going through spiritual awakening. When you go through a spiritual awakening, your anxiety amps up so high, and it's really, really difficult. It's such a common symptom throughout spiritual awakening. So if you're going through a spiritual awakening and you're getting anxiety, it's probably because of the awakening. That's the key indicator. And of course, you can get anxiety without going through a spiritual awakening, but if you tend to find that you're becoming very, very sensitive and things trigger your anxiety very easily, you're probably in spiritual awakening territory. And if you have any questions about this, guys, let me know below. If you're not sure, does this mean I'm having awakening? Does this not? You know, this happens with my anxiety. Let me know below and I'll take a few questions. But generally, that's what you're looking for. Things that trigger it, things that make it worse, being around frequencies, being around electrical items, if it amps up, spiritual awakening and anxiety. If it has no discernible cause, spiritual awakening anxiety. If it massively reduces, this is the key one, if it massively reduces when you avoid spiritual items or practices, it's spiritual awakening anxiety. Okay, so you can employ all of those things and probably see a really big difference just by removing them from your day or for a few days, and you'll notice that there are big changes there. And then of course we need to get into talking about the best way to stop it. What is the best way to really stop it and keep it away as quickly as you can? Because that's the thing, if you're feeling anxious right now, I know you're looking for an answer. So I'm not going to waste time explaining stuff. Let's just get into what's going to change it. So, of course, number one would be avoid spiritual stimulants. Like I said before, spiritual objects, spiritual practices, cut them out of your daily life for a couple of days, even up to 2 weeks. If you do that for 2 weeks, you could feel completely transformed. I'm not kidding. It can affect your spiritual awakening in such a big way. And don't worry, if you want to know all the info about why that happens, how it happens, what you can do to make it easier, I'm going to explain about the free masterclass at the end that you can watch. But the best way that I have found to stop it is EFT. EFT, it stands for Emotional Freedom Technique, and it is an alternative healing method that you can use. It's absolutely easy to apply to yourself, and it's actually how I stopped my anxiety myself. I used to have terrible anxiety, and I had panic attacks all the time. I would wake up with anxiety attacks, even when I was sleeping, the anxiety would wake me out of my sleep. It was absolutely horrendous, and nothing I did took it away, but EFT did. Now, EFT is very easy to learn. You can learn it in under 10 minutes, which we actually teach in the free masterclass, so there's more about that in a second. You can learn it super, super quick, and all it involves is tapping on really the end of energy meridian points. So you're tapping on really acupressure points on specific points around the body. It's very simple, and you get guided through the entire process, and the points never change. And we do that, we tap on those points and we stimulate those points while mentioning the issue that we've got. So it would be anxiety. And the technique's very, very simple. Even children can do it. And when you do that, the tapping on those specific acupressure points is actually dissolving energy blocks and really allowing the energy to flow more easily throughout your energy system, creating a big change, calming the body down. But more than that, it deals with the energy part, which we need, right? It's also going to ground your energies, and that's the thing that makes the difference when you are feeling so much anxiety and awakening. You must ground your energies. But this standard old stuff of, using incense or doing meditation or listening to tones or whatever it is, it's just not enough. And I know that from my own experience and from working with hundreds and hundreds of people throughout the awakening process. It's just not enough for us. Our energies are too volatile. So you really need to use something a bit more heavy duty, and EFT is the best thing that I've found. So it's going to clear any energy blocks. It's going to ground your energies. And the other fantastic thing about it is, while it's bringing this healing, it's also bringing your body out of the fight or flight response. They've done studies on it to test this, and what they've found is that it can calm the stress response of your brain down like a dimmer switch. So not only is it getting you out of the panic and the anxiety and the fear in the moment, so we can do that in 10 minutes flat, we can completely change how you feel. Not only is it going to do that, but it's going to make you less prone to getting anxious and being really worked up going forward. So you'll have less frequent attacks of the anxiety as you move forward. It's such a fantastic technique. It was what I based my entire practice on to begin with. It is just such a wonderful healing tool, super easy to learn. And we're going to show you all of that in the masterclass. So I'll tell you a little bit about it. I just want to say hi to everyone who's joined us so far. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hi to Stacey and hi to Jackson too, and anyone else watching with anxiety, because I know how tough it is. Like, it's really the worst part of awakening, but it doesn't have to be that way. So in the free masterclass that we've just come up with, it's called From Anxious to Awakened in Just 3 Easy Steps, and it is a jam-packed free on-demand video that you can watch right now. And what we'll do is we'll take you through an understanding of why anxiety happens throughout the awakening process and what you really need to do to be able to shift it long term. So it's not about just, having a chamomile tea and burning some incense and maybe you'll feel calmer today. It's about actually putting things in place that are releasing the anxiety and the pressure that's built up today and resetting your system energetically and your nervous system so that you are really protected from that anxiety going forward as well. It's the most comprehensive webinar that we've ever done, and you can get it for free. I want you guys to have all the information that you need to be able to tackle this, because I don't want you to feel the way that I did. No one should be feeling that in awakening. It's a wonderful time, and you should be able to enjoy it without tons of anxiety. So we'll show you absolutely everything that you need to know, and we'll be doing some of that healing technique, that EFT. I'll be guiding you through it in the video live so that you can try it out on your anxiety right now. So don't miss it. The link is in the description. You can take a look right now and get started on that anxiety. Don't live with it any longer than you need to. 3 months from now, 3 years from now, it's still going to be the same. I know, because I did it for years. You don't need to do that. Get it changed now, and let's help you out. So click the link below and you'll be able to get started. And of course, click to be notified whenever we go live or whenever we upload a new video, because we love sharing this with you guys. And I don't want you to be anxious. Don't be anxious, please. Feel better and see you soon.